Good morning, boys and girls. This is Jordan again. This is lesson number 43. So we're going to move on in our books of the Bible, and we're going to open up with a word of prayer, and then we're going to get started. Okay, let's bow our heads. Dear Lord, thank you so much for this wonderful day. Thank you for your word. Thank you for the boys and girls and families listening. And Lord, I just pray as I teach your word that it would be clear and understandable, and that people can take your word, these boys and girls, and hide it in their heart and build a foundation so that when they grow older, they'll have that foundation laid to help direct their lives through your word. We thank you for our salvation and for your dying on Calvary's cross to pay for our sins. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay, now boys and girls, today this is lesson 43. And you're going to see, I'm going to show you your worksheets first. Now, these worksheets, there's two worksheets, three worksheets, and a coloring page. So there's not a lot of exciting things to do, but we're going to cover this stuff today. So if you'd like to color this page, this is Paul, our apostle, and we're going to be talking about Paul's epistles. And of course, he wrote 13 books. And you can color this page if you'd like, this kind of a coloring page. And it says, these are the letters to the church, the church, the body of Christ, for this age in which we live, the dispensation of grace. Okay. Then there's two worksheets, and then there's a word search for you to do. So that's what you're going to have to do today. Okay. So we're going to start out today now. We finished the book of Acts, and we showed how the transition in the book of Acts, and the transition came from the time past to the but now. So in Acts chapter 9, if you remember, Saul got saved on the road to Damascus, and God gave him a new message. And we're going to talk about that message today. So now we're actually out of Acts chapter 9, and I'm going to put here Paul's epistles, and then we'll list his epistles, okay? So that's the but now. Now, why do we have an ages to come, a but now, time past, ages to come, and a, all right, let's say that right. Time past, but now, and ages to come. Why do we study our Bible like that? Okay, so if you turn in your Bible to 2 Timothy 2, now most of you know this verse, but this is why we break our Bible up like that. But boys and girls, this is how the Bible is written. God Almighty wrote and put the Bible in this order. We men did not do that, okay? 2 Timothy 2:15. It says, study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. So that's what God's word tells us to do, is to rightly divide the word. So do we want to go back here in time past and take all of Israel's program and try to follow it? Boys and girls, we don't live in Jerusalem. We don't have a temple. We don't have to do animal sacrifices like they had to sacrifice the lambs and all that kind of stuff. We don't have all those laws and rules and regulations to follow, because Jesus saved Saul on the road to Damascus, and he gave him a new message. And that's what we're doing, is we're rightly dividing God's word. We're studying this new message. Okay, so let's kind of get into this new message now. Paul's epistles are laid out, Romans through Philemon, and they're laid out in an order. And as we go through, I'm going to read 2 Timothy 3:16. This is what we're going to learn about these books. 2 Timothy 3:16. All scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good works. So God Almighty laid out Paul's epistles in an order. All scripture is given by inspiration of God. And it's profitable for doctrine, reproof, and correction. Now we're going to take this verse and we're going to put it on Paul's epistles, okay? And we'll start next week with the book of Romans, but I want you to remember that. Paul's epistles were not written, he did not write them in the order that they're put in the Bible. God Almighty put them in the Bible in the order he wanted them in. So sometimes as you get older and you start studying, people say, well, why are they not in the order that Paul wrote them? They're in the order God needed them because of the content of what is in each one, okay? So that just put in the back of your head, because that's what we're going to try to remember to do each week as we talk about these books of Paul's epistles. Okay, so let's kind of overview here. Contrast. We're going to do prophecy and mystery here. Okay, so in all the Old Testament and in Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John in the first part of Acts, we saw that Israel rejected Jesus Christ as their king and their Messiah. So God blinded them temporarily. They're not out. Remember, they got three strikes. God blinded them and postponed the fulfillment of the promises of a kingdom on the earth. Now remember, we're rightly dividing God's word. All right, so then he saved... Saul on the road to Damascus. He called him to be the Apostle Paul, and he's the Apostle of the Gentiles. Now, if you look at Romans 11, 13, it says, For I speak to you Gentiles, inasmuch as I am the apostle of the Gentiles, I magnify mine office. In other words, Paul's preaching and he's like, I am the apostle to the Gentiles, okay? I am the one God chose to bring this special message to the Gentiles. So let's look at something now. God, the Lord Jesus Christ, when he was on earth, he called out 12 apostles. So here's Jesus and he called 12 apostles. And they had a message that they preached. Now we're going to look at two verses. And I want you to look at these real carefully, because this is the difference, boys and girls, between prophecy and mystery. Remember, prophecy is something that's foretold to happen. What is a mystery? It's a secret. Okay? So we're going to turn to Acts chapter 3, okay? We're going to look at two verses. So we're going to turn to Acts chapter 3. And I want you to listen very carefully. Now, boys and girls, this lesson is pretty, I kind of think it's kind of heavy for you. So I want you to listen real carefully. Acts chapter 3, verse 21. There's some words in here that you need to listen to. Whom the heaven must receive, okay? And look at verse 20. And he shall send Jesus Christ, which before was preached unto you. The Old Testament told him Jesus was coming. Whom the heaven must receive until the times of restitution of all things. In other words, till everything is put back in order. And it's time for him to come back and fix it all, which God has spoken by the mouth of all his holy prophets since the world began. In other words, boys and girls, God spoke by all of his holy prophets since the world began, since creation. And he spoke these things to Israel. These are what's going to happen. Your kingdom of heaven is come. Your kingdom of heaven on the earth is coming. And, you know, God spoke all this through the prophets, the prophecy of what's going to happen in the ages to come. So back here, Back here, boys and girls, God spoke through the prophets, talking about the ages to come for Israel on the earth. Okay, so that's what the verse says. So, but he spoke this since the world began. Now, I want you to turn in your Bible to Romans 16, and we're going to look at verse 15. So God spoke, these 12 apostles, what they did, these 12 apostles preached things which God has spoken by the mouth of all his prophets since the world began. Okay. Now, look at Romans 16, 25. Now to him that is of power to establish you according to my gospel. Now, Paul wrote the book of Romans. It's his gospel. And the preaching of Jesus Christ according to the revelation of the mystery. There's that word, the secret, which was kept secret since the world began. Okay, so now, boys and girls, think. In Acts chapter 3, all the holy prophets spoke since the world began. They spoke all the prophecy about Israel and their kingdom to come on the earth. Now, Paul got a secret message, and this, but it was kept secret since the world began. So nobody knew this secret mystery until Paul. He's writing this in the book of Romans. So, now here's the question. Are things kept secret since the world began the same as things spoken since the world began? If something's kept secret, it's a secret. If something is spoken, it's not. So the prophecy came about those ages to come, but the secret, boys and girls, the mystery was about this but now time period that God didn't tell anybody about until he saved Saul on the road to Damascus. So, Romans through Philemon are letters. These letters are called epistles. The Apostle Paul wrote these epistles. Every one of his epistles that he wrote starts out with his name. Like 1 Corinthians, Paul called to be an apostle of Jesus Christ. Let's see what Romans says. Paul, a servant of Jesus Christ. And on we could go. All 13 of his epistles start with a greeting from him. Okay? So, they're written to the church, the body of Christ, right in here in the but now. They're not written to Israel. Some of the stuff in them is about Israel and what's going to happen to Israel, but they're not written to them. We're rightly dividing God's word into time past, but now, and ages to come. And if you have time and your mom wants to, you can turn to Ephesians 2 and read those terms. So God tells you how to do it, okay? So remember, things kept secret since the world began are not the same as things told or spoken since the world began. Since the world began is the beginning. The prophecy was told. The secret mystery was not. Okay, so just want you to get that straight. Now, this, and what this secret mystery is the books of Romans or Philemon are written to the church, the body of Christ, and it is composed now, boys and girls, of both Jew and Gentile. This explains the new plan that God calls the mystery and the new age called the dispensation of grace. We're living under God's grace now, boys and girls. So believers today who desire to be established in the faith must understand Paul's message and his gospel, which is the preaching of Jesus Christ according to the revelation of the mystery. So that's real important that you understand there's a mystery program, which is not a mystery anymore, and there's a prophecy program. Okay? Now, if you remember, prior to Paul, Jesus had chosen his 12 apostles. And the reason there are 12, you remember why there are 12? 12 tribes of Israel. Each one of these men represents a tribe of Israel, the sons of Jacob. Okay? So don't ever forget that. All right. Paul is not one of these 12. So I'm going to read Romans 11, 13 to you, okay? For I speak to you Gentiles, I just read this to you, inasmuch as I am the apostle of the Gentiles, I magnify my office. Paul was not one of the 12. He is a new apostle that God chose on the road to Damascus that day, okay? But an interesting thing is Paul was he was Jewish and he was Roman. So he was Jew and Gentile, and God saved him. And that's a pattern that now Jews and Gentiles together are saved the same way, okay? By trust, believing that Jesus died on the cross, according to the scriptures, that he was buried, that he rose again the third day, according to the scriptures, that he died there for your sins, okay? And the body of Christ today is composed of Jews and Gentiles. So there's a new whole body of believers now. And Paul is teaching to this new body of believers here. Here he is, teaching to this new body of believers, right? And it's Jew and Gentile. Okay, 1 Corinthians, now let's look at 1 Corinthians 12, and I'll read this verse 7. 12:27, I'm sorry, here we go. Now ye are the body of Christ and members in particular. So now we have the church, the whole body of Christ, and Christ is the head, okay? So now we are in, and all of this is, we're going to read, all of this you learn in Paul's epistles. So that's why we're just doing an overview right now of Paul's epistles. So we live in the dispensation of the grace of God. So Israel lived under the law. So I'm going to turn back and we're going to look at Romans 6:14. Now you know Israel lived under the law, Moses' law. He went up on the mountain, he got it, he came down, he got mad, he threw it down, broke it, had to go back and get it again. Okay, so Moses and Israel, they all lived under the law. But through Paul, God says, Romans 6:14, for sin shall not have dominion over you, for ye are not under the law, but under grace. Grace, boys and girls, is God's free to do all for you that he wants to do. And he did it all on Calvary's cross for you and gave you so many spiritual blessings and so many things to be thankful for and excited for. Ephesians chapter 3, verse 2. Now, let's go look at that. So you can understand, we live in what is called the dispensation of the grace of God. Ephesians chapter 3, verse 2. Okay, if ye have heard of the dispensation of the grace of God, which is given me to you. So this is Paul writing. He's saying, if you have heard of the dispensation of the grace of God. Okay, a dispensation is a dispensing of facts. When your moms and dads or grandparents were smaller, they would go to the dispensary. And that was like you go to the pharmacy today. And at the dispensary, they would dispense out the medicine. They would hand it out. So a dispensation is a dispensing of information. And it's done in time frames, okay? So this is a dispensation which is given to me to you, word, how that by revelation he made known unto me the mystery. So Paul is now dispensing and giving out to the people the information about the mystery. So remember, we don't live under the law program now. We live under the grace of the dispensation of the grace of God. So in Paul's epistles, he's giving out, he's dispensing God's word to us. Now there's a new gospel. So let's look. I'm going to turn back to Mark. Excuse me, chapter 1. I'm going to take a drink real fast. Okay, so now today we have a new gospel. So the gospel of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, and the beginning of Acts is the gospel of the kingdom. So Mark 1:14. Now, after that, John was put in prison. Jesus came into Galilee, preaching the gospel of the kingdom of God. So Jesus, the 12 apostles, all taught the gospel of the kingdom of God. Today, okay, it is, now that gospel is good news that Jesus Christ, the Son of God, came to be Israel's Messiah and King. He was ready to establish that promised kingdom. That's why he preached. The time is full. Okay, Mark 1:15. Let's do that. And saying, the time is fulfilled, and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent ye and believe the gospel. That was the gospel of the kingdom. So, that's why when the believers believed, thou art the Son of God, thou art the King of Israel, they were believing the gospel of the kingdom of God, that Jesus was their Messiah and their King. Now, in early Acts, the apostles spoke about the cross like it was bad news. They didn't want the Lord to go to the cross and be killed because they did not understand that secret, that mystery that had not been spoken since the world began. The apostles didn't understand that. They had crucified their Christ, and they needed to repent of it and believe that he was their promised Messiah, the Son of God. Now, repent means changing your thinking, changing your mind, okay? The gospel, the good news, was that they, if they did repent, God would send Jesus Christ back to establish his kingdom. Now, that's what they had to do. They had to repent, believe, be baptized, and God would bring back the kingdom. But boys and girls, they didn't do it. They rejected God the Father, God the Son, and then God the Holy Spirit with the stoning of Stephen. Now, that message is not what Paul preached, okay? Paul preaches that same Jesus and the same cross, but he received new information about the events that happened, about the cross, okay? We're going to read in Romans. I'm going to read a couple passages here, okay? Romans chapter 3, if you have your Bible. And we're going to read verses 21, let's find it, to 25. So this is the message Paul preached. The Lord Jesus Christ and the apostles preached the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Repent, believe, be baptized. But Paul, this is his message. But now the righteousness of God without the law is manifested, being witnessed by the law and prophets, okay? Even the righteousness of God, which is by faith, of Jesus Christ unto all and upon all them that believe, for there is no difference. There's no difference between the Jew and Gentile. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Boys and girls, the message that Jesus and the apostles had was to the nation of Israel. The message that Paul has is to individuals. And his message is, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, being justified freely by his grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, whom God has set forth to be a propitiation through faith in his blood, through the shedding of his blood, to declare his righteousness for the remissions of sins that are past through the forbearance of God. So the cross was to declare Christ's righteousness and the fact that he died there for all our sins. Okay? That was Paul's message. Peter and the 12 and Jesus, their message was, behold, the Lamb of God that take away the sins of the world. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. Repent, be baptized. Paul's message is, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And the Lord Jesus Christ went to the cross to pay for all sins. All right, now let's look at verse 28. Therefore, we conclude that a man is justified by faith without the deeds of the law. All you have to do is have faith in Jesus Christ and what he did for you. Israel had to do a lot of stuff to prove that they love the Lord. We have to believe that Jesus died on the cross to pay for our sins. Okay? So we have a new gospel, and it's the gospel of the grace of God. Boys and girls, mankind is evil. And man, you know, mankind, no, we all do bad things. And we deserve to spend eternity in hell. But when Jesus died on the cross that day, he paid for all of our sins. This says, for the remissions of sins that are past. So he died for our past sins, our present sins, and our future sins. And now Jew and Gentile have to believe the same thing. That Jewish people have to believe like we do today to get saved and go to heaven to be with the Lord. Okay, look at Romans 4:25. Let's see. Who was delivered for our offenses and was raised again for our justification. What is justification? When Jesus died on the cross and paid for our sins, and then we believe and trust him, it's just as if I'd never sinned because he took care of my sins. Okay, so we've had, let's see, we have a new apostle. And we're a new body of believers, the body of Christ. We live in the dispensation of the grace of God. We are not a part of the prophecy program. We're the mystery program. We have our new gospel is the gospel of the grace of God, not the gospel of the kingdom. And boys and girls, we have a new hope, and that's a home eternal in heaven. So no one, now listen, boys and girls, in the Old Testament, in the Gospels, or the early part of Acts, was promised an eternal home in heaven. Okay. Remember, what was the Abrahamic covenant? God promised Abraham a land, a people and a land on the earth. Christ, in his earthly ministry, promised believers eternal life in the kingdom of God on earth. So I'm just going to read, there's a bunch of verses here, but I'm going to read Matthew 5. Let's turn back to Matthew 5, okay? If you have your Bible, Matthew 5. Oh, here we are. And verse 5. Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Okay. Let's look at Deuteronomy. Now go back to Deuteronomy. So you would get the earth thing, okay? Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy. Chapter 11, verse 21. Okay. That your days may be multiplied, and he's talking to Israel, and that the days of your children in the land which the Lord sware unto your fathers to give them, as the days of heaven upon the earth. So Israel's program, boys and girls, was a promise of a kingdom on the earth. Ours is not that. So now let's look at Philippians chapter 3, okay? Now, I hope you're still with me here. I know this is a lot of turning in Bibles, but this is important to know and to understand that we're rightly dividing God's word, and we're doing it according to what the Apostle Paul gives us to do. So, Philippians 3, verse 20. Wrong chapter. Wasn't going to say what I wanted it to say. For our conversation is in heaven, from whence also we look for the Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. All right, now let's turn back to 2 Corinthians chapter 5. Okay, 2 chapter 5, verse 1. For we know that our earthly house of this tabernacle were dissolved. We have a building of God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. Boys and girls, our hope is eternal life in heaven with Jesus. Israel's hope is eternal life on the earth in the kingdom with Jesus, okay? So, our home and our hope is that house made with not hands, eternal in the heavens. So, we have a different hope than Israel had. And you know, boys and girls, that's a wonderful thing because we know that when we die, we're going to go to heaven to be with the Lord if we've trusted Jesus as our Savior. Now, you know, sometimes we have people pass away in our lives, our grandparents, our friends, or somebody, and we know that they trusted Jesus as our Savior. Then, boys and girls, we know one day we will see them again. And we have that hope only because we've trusted Christ as our Savior. People that have not trusted Christ as their Savior won't see their loved ones in heaven. They're going to spend that eternity in hell. So that's something to think about, boys and girls. Okay, so now let's go back and let's review. Okay, we are learned today there's a prophecy and a mystery. prophecy was what was foretold about the ages to come, that kingdom. The mystery was that secret, kept secret since the world began, that mystery that Jesus died on Calvary's cross to pay for everyone's sin and to justify us. That's wonderful, boys and girls. We have a totally different mystery message than Israel had. Now, the other thing that we have that we're going to learn about in Paul's epistles is the catching away of the body of Christ before that great tribulation. Now, boys and girls, when we talked through those Old Testament books, we talked about God warning Israel that great tribulation is coming. That great and notable day of the Lord. We talked about those things. But boys and girls, we're not going to go through that. Okay, so during Christ's earthly ministry, he was preparing Israel's believers, the believers in Israel, for that great tribulation. And they know that it's going to come before the establishment of the kingdom. That's what is in the book of Daniel, Isaiah, it's in the book of Revelation. All of that, you know, they talked about that great and notable day of the Lord, and then the great tribulation that's coming. So I want you to turn in your Bible to 1 Thessalonians, and we're going to look at chapter 1, and we're going to look at verse 10, okay? Now, it says, and to wait for his son from heaven, we're waiting for the Lord to come back to get us, whom he raised from the dead, even Jesus, which delivered us from the wrath to come. Boys and girls, there's a tribulation time coming. And if I can get my little sheet in here, I'll kind of show you. We have time past, but now, right in here between that and that, we're gone. He's taken us out. That great tribulation is going to happen right in there in that ages to come. And it's going to be a horrible day for the people on the earth. The Lord is going to come back and clean up the whole earth. And everybody is then going to turn to worship him when he's done. It's going to take a while, okay? So, but he has delivered us, it says, from the wrath to come. That's our hope of eternal glory, okay? Now, I'm going to read 1 Thessalonians 4, 16 and 17. And this is the rapture. We call it the rapture, but it's the catching away of the body of Christ. This is how we're going to miss that wrath to come. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with the shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Boys and girls, if you die and if you've trusted the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior, and you die, you're going to go to heaven. If you're still here when the Lord comes back to get us, you're still going to heaven with him, okay? So, but one thing we have to remember is God's plan is to gather in one all things. Let me read this verse to you, Ephesians chapter 1, verse 10, okay? Here we go. That in the dispensation of the fullness of time, he might gather together in one all things in Christ, both which are in heaven and which are on earth, even in him. That's going to be a day, boys and girls, when the Lord is going to rule over everything. And he'll have everything in heaven. Satan will be cast into the bottomless pit and then into the lake of fire. And everyone in heaven and earth is all going to be to worship the Lord Jesus Christ. That is what his plan is to gather everybody together and make everyone, the whole earth and the whole heaven will be worshiping and serving him. Okay. So redeemed Israel will one day reign with him in the kingdom on earth. But the body of Christ, boys and girls, will reign in the heavens with him. So that's just kind of an overview of Paul's epistles. So next week we'll start in the book of Romans, and we're going to talk about the doctrine, reproof, and correction too. So next week that'll be where we go, and we start with the book of Romans, okay? So don't forget, your worksheets are there, color sheet. Then you have two worksheets. And boys and girls, they're easy. The answers, an epistle is a letter. And remember, that's right. Romans through Philemon are letters or books. You pick the word that Paul wrote to the churches. They are sometimes called church epistles or Pauline epistles because Paul wrote them. Okay, so the questions are not hard. There's just a lot of them because there's two pages. And it goes through all that we just talked about today, and then you'll have your word search, okay? So that's all for today, just an overview. I hope you weren't too bored today, okay? But it's real important to learn how and why we rightly divide God's word, because when you rightly divide God's word, the Bible makes a whole lot of sense to you. And that's what we've done here. We've made our right divisions, our time past, our but now, starting in Acts 9, and we'll write the other books in as we go, and our ages to come. And that sets your Bible up so easy for you to understand when you study it. All right, boys and girls, I love you. And I'm so, hope you're having a wonderful summer. I hope you're out of school. And going to have a wonderful summer, and we'll see you next week. Good night. Goodbye. Good day.